Okay, Hari Om. Let's start with the prayer. Om Samasta Jana Kalyani Niratam Karunamayam Namami Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsachanura Mardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum Tvameva Mata Cha Pita Tvameva Tvameva Bandhusya Sakhatvameva Tvameva Vidya Dravidam Tvameva Tvameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva Tvameva Sarvam Guru Deva Deva. Hari Om. We are doing the Vedanta Sangraha of Sri Ramaraya Kavi, and we are the 6th chapter where he is talking about Lakshyartha, indicatory meaning to indicate that this is Brahman. So scripture teaches that which cannot be taught, and through using a Lakshyartha means you took in that direction. Scripture says this is Brahman because Brahman cannot be pointed out, being infinite. At the same time, scripture is telling you how to know Tadvijnana Artham Sa Gurumeva Abhigachet Samit Pani Sotriyam Brahma Nishtam Tadvidhi Pranipatena Pariprasnena Sevaya. So you go to a teacher, Krishna says Tadvidhi Pranipatena. In order to know that, you go to a teacher with an attitude of humility. And the same thing scripture talks about. So Tadvijnana Artham Sa Gurumeva Abhigachet. Go to a teacher. And teacher is going to teach by Shabda Pramana. He is going to communicate through the words. How can he communicate through the words that which cannot be communicated? Through the Lakshyartha. And he said there are three types of Lakshyarthas, indicatory meanings. One is Jahal Lakshana, Ajahal Lakshana, Jahal Ajahal Lakshana. Jahal Lakshana involves completely taking out the meaning, direct meaning, and take only implied but related to that. And simple example that provided is classical example is the village on the river. There is a village on the river. This is how can there be village on the river? Because river is a continuous on the Ganges. And how can there be a river on the Ganges? It means only river on the bank of Ganges. So it is related to the Ganges, but at the same time not on the river, but on the bank. Next to river is the Lakshyartham. That's what he wanted to communicate, and that's only the meaning that can be applied, because direct meaning has no meaning. That's called Ajahal Lakshana. Leave the original meaning, take the related meaning. And the Ajahal Lakshana is take the original meaning only, but add to it to make it some sense also. And therefore, it is a not rejection of that, but at the same time, an implied, not instead of directly, and implied meaning is, of the example that is given is, the umbrella people are walking. So umbrella people have everybody is not umbrella people. So there are two types of people, one with the umbrella, one without an umbrella. And in fact, you can say there are people who are walking, and there in that walking, there are people who are with umbrellas and without umbrellas. And here the walking, umbrella people only walking, the people who are not having umbrellas are just standing there watching, could be whatever they are doing. So implication is there are two people that has to be implied, of which only umbrella people are walking. And that's what essentially implied. We are not leaving the original meaning, but add something else to make a common sense. If everybody is walking, we don't say umbrella people are walking. Even non-umbrella people also walking. So obviously, a communication involves some kind of information that is not obvious. So only umbrella people means there are other people without umbrellas are not walking. That's what the implication is. And that's called Ajahal Lakshana. Now we have talked about these two discussed. And we'll take the third category called Jahal Ajahal Lakshana. Okay, swarthaika desha parityagaha Swarthaika desha aparichyagascha yatra sa jahat ajahat swartha iti soyam devadattaha. So here, swartha eka desha swartha aparichyagascha swartha eka swartha swartha aneka desha aparichyagascha yatra sa jagat ajaha swartha yatha so somadattaha. So you live part of it, you live, keep part of it, but at the same time, so you live part of it, but you retain part of it and make sense out of it. That's what essentially is involved in the jahat ajaha lakshana. Ajahad, the ajahad means you have to leave it, jahat means you have to include it. This involves both. Only part of it is removed, left, and it's also called Bhagatyaga Lakshana. Jahat Ajaha Lakshana is also called Bhagatyaga Lakshana. Only Bhaga is Tyagam. Only part of it is removed, is discarded. Only part is taken, and that's what Jahat Ajaha Lakshana. And the example is Soyam Devadatta. A very classical example is Soyam Devadatta. Soyam Devadatta means this is that Devadatta. So this is that Devadatta, the instruction given by a teacher to a friend or teacher says, hey, you know, see, this is that Devadatta. So what is this? So there are two things. This is Devadatta and that is Devadatta. And he's combining both. This is that Devadatta. So what does that mean? It means that Devadatta, you remember long time ago at a different time, different space, and he may be very cute little boy, or he may be a young fellow or running around with all the things, and here we have a Devadatta here which is different completely, and he is giving a swami and is giving a lectures here. And we never thought that Devadatta will be like this. So in instruction say, hey, you know, this is that Devadatta. So obviously that Devadatta, a different time, different space, spatially different, and attributes of that Devadatta is completely different. And this Devadatta, which is in a different time and different space, and the attributes of this Devadatta is completely opposite to that Devadatta. So what is the equation? But equation is this Devadatta is same as that Devadatta. So I should have the knowledge of what that Devadatta is in order to make sense out of it. So a teacher says this is that Devadatta. That means he understood that the teacher or the friend knows that I know that Devadatta also. And now I am seeing this Devadatta. So this Devadatta is same as that Devadatta in spite of. The attributes are completely different, time is different, spatial coordinates are different. So all that are Bhagatyagam, are removing that. So you are discard everything on that sense, that is called the Ajahat part. And Jahat part is retained something. What is retained? Devadatta part is retained. Means the intrinsic nature of Devadatta, that individual Devadatta, which has nothing to do with us, changing attributes don't qualify the Devadatta only. His particular Devadatta, that Devadatta is same in spite of the so essence of Devadatta is there, which is equated. All attributes, contradictory attributes are dropped out. Only that which common attributes between the two are retained. So there is a Bhagatyagam, or partly is removed, at the same time part is retained, and therefore this Ajahat part, which is the discarded part, because attributes of this Devadatta, attributes of that Devadatta, the spatial coordinates of this Devadatta, spatial coordinates of that Devadatta, the time span, you may be young boy at that time and he is an old person here, all that are discarded, only retained is Devadatta, essence of that Devadatta and essence of this Devadatta is same. Immediately, the one who knows that Devadatta and the other one seeing this Devadatta at the same time knows, oh my God, he is that Devadatta. So that means he understood and he knows how to equate what and how to discard what. That's what called Jahalakshana. An important point is the teacher is indicating, because the teacher should know, hey, this is that, so he knows that Devadatta and this Devadatta also for the teacher. And the student also is seeing this Devadatta, and he may not know that Devadatta, he may know it, but in order to, it's an instruction by the teacher to indicate that is Devadatta that you are seeing here, in spite of wrong, the contradictory qualifications, and only the one who is familiar with these two Devadattas, who can take only the essence out of it, discarding the attributes, can understand the meaning of this is that Devadatta. So there are prerequisites in order to make a meaning out of this is that Devadatta, and the teacher can make, hey, you remember that Devadatta? Oh, I don't know who is what is that Devadatta? I've never seen him before. Then that meaning will not have any implication. Only if I am familiar with that Devadatta and I am seeing this Devadatta and equating these two, that makes Jahal Adhal Lakshana. So the teaching also implies that there is a certain qualifications for the listener in order to appreciate in order to drop the contradictory statements and only equate the essence of it, implied essence of it, and then only the Jahal Ajahal Lakshana will be work. And this is exactly the type of teaching. So you need a person who is prepared and who knows what that you want to know, and what this one, the attributes of that, the attributes of this, only equate the essence of it, leaving all other contradictory attributes are to be left out, on equate the essence, and that's what is essentially implied in that. All that is so in this very classical example of the Jahal Ajahal Lakshana, also called Bhagatyaga Lakshana. Soyam Devadattaha Atra Tat Shabdasya Tat Desha Tat Kala Viseshe Saktihi. So Tat that Devadatta, that part, the word that implies the particular meaning of the space and particular meaning of the time, all are associated with that Devadatta. Remember, long time ago when you were kids, when you were playing around, one fellow who was all the time running around with all that Devadatta. So there is a spatial coordinates and time wise that is indicated by that. And here it says Atra Tat Shabdasya Tat Desha Tat Kala Viseshe Shaktihi. So it is a Shakti, it is giving the meaning of that, includes the space and the time also, and also attributes also. So other attributes, therefore is a young, energetic, and wants, well, extroverted fellow, all that is implied in that's Shakti. Shakti means the word that has the implied meaning of that. Idam Shabdasya Yetadesha Yetat Kala Vishesha Shaktihi. And this Devadatta, this aspect, say this is that, so this is, so is and this also, the current existing and what you are seeing, and that was Devadatta, this is Devadatta, and this is that Devadatta, obviously this is, that was all added together, and in the implication of this is talking about this particular time and this particular space that the listener is very much familiar. The listener may not be familiar with that and that unless he has gone through what is that before. So essentially here idam shabdasya etadesha etatkala vishesha shaktihi uvayoho arthayoho aikyam asambhavat taddesha tatkala etaddesha etatkala chaga purvakam suddha devadatta lakshana. So here is giving a complete detail here. Ubayoho arthayoho aikya, and says this is that devata. Is involves an equation of equating this devadatta and that devadatta, and the equation to be valid. So idam sabdasya the ubayoho arthayoho aikya asambhavat. It's impossible to equate this devadatta and that devadatta, and tat desa tat kala etat desa et kala, that time and that space and that attribute you there is, and this space and this time and these attributes associated with this devadatta. Says chaga purvakam suddha devadatta lakshanam has to be understood. So before rejecting all that, what has to be equated is that Suddha Devadatta. Suddha Devadatta means pure Devadatta. Pure Devadatta is the essence of Devadatta alone is equated, dropping everything else. So dropping everything involves is the Ajat part, and keeping something common is Ajahat part, and together Jahat Ajahat Lakshana is involved in this Lakshana Vakya. Purvaka Suddha Devadatta Lakshana. Atha Satchidanandam Brahma. Atha in the same way. Satchit Anandam Brahma. So here is indicating Satchit Anandam is Brahman. So Satchit Anandam is Satyam Jnanam Anantam. Is Satyam Chit the consciousness Anandam Brahma. When scripture says Brahman is nothing but Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, Satchit Anandam Brahma, Tadeva Samyaitam, that is Brahman. So when he is pointing out as though Sat and Chit and Ananda. Sat is the real, the Chit is consciousness, and the Ananda is the bliss. So the existent consciousness bliss of Brahman. So are the attributes of Brahman? Because it's not, Brahman cannot have attributes. And here he says, Atha Satchidanandam Brahma, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. Another way he's saying is Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, Satchidanandam Brahma. Says Tat, this is from the Taittiriya Upanishad, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. That is a statement in the Taittiriya Upanishad. And Anando Brahma is, this is another statement in the scriptures, is pure bliss is nothing but Brahman. Ityadi sutayaha jahat ajahat lakshanaya brahma paripadayanti. So here it's stating ityadi, in this way sutayaha, the scriptures uses jahat ajahat lakshanaya, through jahat ajahat lakshana brahma paripadayanti, the indicatory meaning of Brahman is being discussed by the scripture. So, in say Satyam Jnanam Anantam, say Swarupa Lakshanam, Lakshavakya. And Satchidananda is also Lakshanavakyam, means indicatory definition. What is indicatory definition? Brahman cannot be indicated. That's number one. So, that which cannot be indicated, but being scripture is indicating how? Through Lakshartham. You look in the direction that is pointed out. So Satyam Jnanam Anantam Satchidananda, then Adaham Brahmasmi or Adaham Anandu Brahma, bliss is pure Brahman. All these are indicatory. Ichyadaya Srutaya Jahat Adahal Lakshanaya Brahma Pratipadayanti. Why is possible? These are Lakshana Vakyas and not descriptors of Brahman. He says Nirdharmake Brahmani Satchatvadi Dharma Yogat Satchit Adi Padanam Suddha Chaitanya Lakshana. So Nirdharmake, Brahman does not have any attributes. Why Brahman does not have any attributes? Nirgunam Brahma says the some acharyas define Nirgunam means he is a dosha rahitam, durguna dosha rahitam Brahma. So they are selective in terms of he does not have the wrong attributes or bad attributes. Durguna dosha rahitam, but he is a saguna Brahma. So it is in fact Bhagavan Ramanuja says, is Ananta Kalyana Gunam, is auspicious, infinite auspicious. That infinite auspicious, that infinite applies to auspiciousness as well as the infinite gunas also. All are the Mangala, all the auspicious virtues, that is what they call it, is an attributive, is of the guna. So he does not have durgunas, therefore nirguna has to be interpreted as the without any durgunas. That's how the Ramanuja is uses a bhagatyagam. So he is removing only durguna part but keeping the saguna part. So he calls Brahman saguna Brahma. Whereas from the Advaita point, Brahman is nirgunam. So why is nirgunam? How can you justify? In fact, all the gunas belong to the prakriti only. So prakriti is the gunatmikam, sattva rajas tamo gunas, and apareyamitastvanyam prakritim vidhime param. So nirguna is this, that guna atitam, guna means is beyond gunas, and that's what is essentially the substantive, the adhara, adhisthana of Ishvara also. So Ishvara, Advaita also agrees that is Ananta Kalyana Gunam. At the same time, that is not Brahman, is only Brahman with Maya Shakti. We call it at the transactional level only for the creation, we use that Ishvara. But from absolute point, it's only Ekamaiva Advitiyam. There is nothing other than Brahman, and in that no words can reach there, because scripture itself says no words can reach. So how can you describe? Ananta Kalyana Gunam you cannot even describe. So Navak Gachati Namanaha. So scripture uses some of the words that is interpreted by the other acharyas differently, where Advaita takes into consideration that infinite cannot have attributes. Why? Because it's infinite. Attributes belong to a finite object. Infinite is not even an attribute. So Anantam is an attribute of him, of Ishvara. So Anantam cannot be attribute. From logically also, infinite means it's not finite. So it's only negation of the things that have attributes of finiteness is negated in the process to point out in the direction. So infinite is also lakshyartha only of infinity. It's like someone asking, say, what is infinity? So when the two parallel lines meet at infinity, so how do you prove that? Someone wanted to ask me recently that, how do you prove that it's Brahman is infinite? So how do you prove that two parallel lines meet at infinity? So you have to go to infinity to find out whether they meet there or not. If you go to there, that's not infinity. It's still finite because you could go there. You cannot go to infinity. So obviously, this is a Shastra Pramanam. Science says that the two lines meet at infinity. That means you don't meet anywhere that you can see or you can find. So anywhere that you can see is a finite place, they are not meeting. Therefore, you assume that they will only meet at infinity. The same way that Brahman is infinity is indicatory to mean that anything finite, anything attributive, anything that has a boundary cannot be Brahman. So essentially, we discard anything that is perceptible or that is deductible and therefore cannot be Brahman. But it is not an imaginary or a belief system. People say, oh, you cannot show me God. If I can show you God, then that one that I showed is not God, because I could show you. So anything that can be seen cannot be God also. That's why scripture is very careful. Say, yachachusha na pasyati, yena chachum sipasyati, tadeva brahma tvambiddhi, nedam nedam upasati. What you are worshipping is not God. So that which you are worshipping, nedam yadidam upasate. So that's not Brahman. What is a Brahman? That chakshushana pasyati, eyes cannot see. Eyes can only see a finite forms. And I am seeing Lord and Vishwarupa Darshanam, because Lord is shown in to Arjuna and also in the court of the Dhritarashtra also, Krishna shows the Virat Swarupam, but there that's only an indicatory seeing only. That's what he describes. He gives a jnana chakshu. He gives a special eyes to see. Special eyes to see is what? To see that which cannot be seen. At the same time, whatever your imagination puts you as Brahman, that's what you will see also. So essentially, you cannot see na chakshusha, you cannot find, you cannot wait, describe it. Therefore, nidharma ke. It is a without dharma means it's nirguna brahma. Satchatvayi darsa yoga satchidadi padanam suddha chaitanya lakshana. It's only indicatory meaning of pure consciousness. Pure consciousness cannot be defined, and that's only indicatory. So even if you look into Google and all that, there are scientists trying to find out what is consciousness. And they are trying to took in terms of in the particular assembly of neurons, all that. They are trying to find out what is consciousness. You cannot find out consciousness. What is consciousness? Objectify consciousness, because consciousness is not an object. Pure consciousness is only infinite. And that's what scripture says. Prajnanam Brahma means consciousness is infinite. And it is used in the converse statement. Prajnanam Brahman is consciousness. He doesn't say consciousness is Brahman. That means it is necessary and sufficient to say what is Brahman is of the nature of consciousness. So in the description, those who are familiar, this is a necessary condition, this is a necessary and sufficient condition. So for example, when I say sweetness of a sugar, sweetness of the sugar is a necessary. If it is the sugar, it has to be sweet. So sugar is sweet is a direct statement, is applicable, because sugar has to be sweet. And if it doesn't look sweet, it looks like a sugar but doesn't, is not sweet, it's not sugar. So that's what is a necessary qualification. A converse, a necessary and sufficient means converse has to be applied. That means if I say sweet is sugar, and sweet is sugar means anything that is sweet has to be sugar. But we know the lot of things which are not sugar, which can be Equal or Splendor, so many other things which are also sweeter that are coming in the market. So therefore, sweet need not be sugar, but sugar has to be sweet. So it is necessary qualification, but not sufficient qualification. For sufficient qualification, converse has to be applicable. And scripture defines in a converse way, consciousness is Brahman, prajnanam Brahma. Consciousness is infinite. That means wherever there is a consciousness, that is Brahman. So a fellow is investigating, a scientist is investigating, what is consciousness? He is looking at a lab, looking at neurons and so on and so forth, and trying to find out. So who is investigating? Conscious entity is investigating, and investigated is an object which is unconscious entity. So essentially, it becomes a joke only, because he cannot, all he can say is under circumstances that particular matter exhibits consciousness. So what Vedanta says is under certain circumstances the matter reflects the consciousness, not consciousness exhibits, it is exhibits by reflected consciousness, pratibimbam. So pure consciousness is always there, it is infinite, Brahman, and it gets as though reflected in the under certain conditions, that is when the material is subtle enough to reflect it. That's what essentially implication here. So evam nirdharma ke brahmani satyatvadi dharma yogat satchit adi padanam suddha chaitanya lakshanam. Therefore it's an indicator meaning of pure consciousness. That's what the statement, this previous statements, satyam, jnanam, anantam, they are indicatory meanings. They are not definitions of the meaning. And that way, it's called lakshyartha. And later, it's called swarupa lakshanam also. that we'll define later. Evam chaitanya padasyapi suddha chaitanye lakshana eva. Even when I say consciousness means only pure, unadulterated consciousness only, that is Brahman. Chit jnana chaitanyam padanam paryayatam. So the consciousness is also called chit jnanam, and chaitanyam are paryayapadam, synonyms for tatha brahma sabdasyapi chaitanye lakshanaiva brahmat swarupa darshanasya tatra ayogat idyapi chit jnana chaitanya padanam paryata tatha brahma sabdasyapi chaitanye lakshanaiva brahma swarupa dharmasya tatra ayogat. So it is a pure consciousness, and it says that the other indicatory definitions are only not really directly applicable. They are only lakshyartham, not the vachyartham. So don't take it as a word direct meaning. You have to take jahat ajaha lakshana in order to make a sense out of it. Lakshanatvam api nidharmake brahmani ayuktam tathapi shastra vyavaharaya kalpitam. So for the shastra, it still uses, even though they are not directly applicable, no words can reach us, still shastra trying to teach, uplift the ignorant person. Shastra vyavahara kalpitam. In the transactional reality, it uses these words in order to make. So Vedanta is only at the vyavaharika level, not at the paramarthika level. So it's only for a guy who is confused, this teaching is useful. For the one who has realized, it has no meaning at all. So therefore, tathapi shastra vyavahara kalpitam, tathapi tatra mayaya. Therefore, it's all maya only. Even this realization, the self-realization, God-realization, even the God also is nothing but within the maya only. So here, we're trying to see how the indicatory meanings can explain and help a seeker to recognize the presence of that which cannot be seen, which cannot be otherwise known. And that's what the scripture becomes a pramana. We'll come back and complete it next time. So this is a lakshana vakya, that's how indicatory meaning of the Brahman. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadasyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.